rest of the artists for being so tonight. Thanks so much for coming along and getting behind the team of people. Excuse me? That would have been a relief today. The 16th Warrior, you are the 16th Warrior this evening, thank you. Let's get a couple of the non-playing Glasgow Warriors members of the squad to talk to us about the game tonight. Let's hear from Fraser Lyle! And Jerry Yanuyanutawa! There you go, your microphone works now, Jerry, and he's not very keen, so he's going to hand it to Fraser for the first answer. First of all, big changes this evening for the starting 15. However, you know, it's a rotational thing. It was kind of expected, Fraser, was it?
It definitely wasn't a surprise to expect the changes, especially some guys had a really long summer in the World Cup, so they've earned a week off, I think. So yeah, the changes were expected.
Greg's been very positive about, as positive as you can be after the defeat, about the performance, and maybe he wasn't as angry as he might have been last week. What do you think the general feeling has been on last week's performance?
I think Greg was disappointed with us. Of course, I think in terms of the standard that Glasgow playing with, it wasn't up to the standards that we're playing for. But hopefully this week, you know, he's been driving to have that change.
Have to have it right up your goal. Your big smiley face, you've got to have it right there, Jerry, right here. We're going to ask you, Chris, we've got sent you in, but possibility of Ryan Grant coming on as well and getting his numbers capped. Chris Cassano definitely will. He'll lead the team out this evening at kickoff. Chris will be a guy that will obviously be here when you started and brought you through the ranks. What would you say about Chris Cassano?
His nickname is Fuzzy, or Gino, because of his Italian heritage. He's a really nice guy, Chris. He's a sort of role model for all the younger guys. He sets the standards in training. He's always going 100%. He's always cleaning up after himself around the stadium. So he set a very high standard in Chris Self to drive that to be one of the senior players. But he's also quite funny. He's got a very dry sense of humour. He is actually quite funny to get to know him.
Brilliant. Well, we've got a new hooker in play. It's always exciting to see debutants in a Glasgow shirt. You'll know maybe a bit more about Shalva, who's a hooker tonight. Tell us a bit more about what you know.
The Georgian Shalva. He doesn't smile much, but you know, he only smiles when you have a good scrum. When you're pushing hard on the boards. Other than that, he just looks at you and, you know, if you stuff up, he just doesn't smile. So he's a good character. He's definitely a nice addition to the team, especially with the injuries that we've had, Paddy and all the other hookers. So, yeah.
Yeah, very sad for Paddy. Wish him all the best. Just how long does it take to adapt to someone new in the front row that you're not familiar with?
He speaks, Charles speaks quite good English. I think he's just spent two seasons down at Sale, so it was quite difficult, but also, and the boys kind of helping through the lines and stuff like that. But last week, it was just a pressure line to put on us. I think that's going to pressure the whole pack. But I think if we go well, then he is very intelligent and he's well as well, so he's trying to learn new things.
Playing against the bottom team tonight in Pro 12, so how much has the message been about not taking that for granted this evening for the Warriors?
There's definitely no complacency tonight. We had Sonny Pavaro, obviously knows a lot of the guys very well, so he spoke to the team during the week, and there'll be no complacency. It's a very difficult team. The conditions are certainly tonight, so they're very physical and aggressive, so if you let them get a foothold in the game, it can be difficult to beat. But if we play tempo, we should have enough to beat them.
Do you feel
we're going to
win, Jenny? What's your thought on
tonight
and the result?
I think we'll win the week comfortably. During the week, I think Greg's been harping on one of the Fraser's strengths. He has been a set piece. I think it'll be seeing last week's performance and the week that lives for that. So I think the boys will be up for that. And I think if we can win the set piece, I reckon obviously our game will be won and won well. So, yeah.
Jerry, thanks so much for joining us.
Also,
Fraser, Jerry Yanuyanutawa, and Fraser Lyle. Cheers, guys. We'll see you again over here at Clubhouse for the future. Just a reminder, we do have the 100-page glossy book available now, and it's on sale here tonight, celebrating our championship winning season last term. Now, there's a cycling session on the go. We've got Al, we've got Peter, we've got Leone, and Fraser Brown, who's in on this here as well. Four of the players involved in that season success. So you can go over there right now, this big inflatable area, you can get under there, and you can get that glossy book signed. which will be a fantastic commemorative night tonight and before what happened last season. Once more, at this point, you can get it signed by those squad members. So do take advantage of that. And also, we're able to take card payments for that as well, which is great news. So head over there, head over for yours for the 100-page glossy book with all the pictures and the story of our Guinness Pro 12 winning season last term. So all that remains to be said is, make sure you make some noise. You are the 16th warrior this evening, and let's cheer on the Glasgow Warriors.